So Bengal origin Muslims, we have seen they are people who originated from Bengal, came to Assam during various times and settled here. Miyah is a street slang which is used against this community. The original meaning of the word Miyah, of course, is well known. It means gentleman. But in Assam, it refers to a person from the community, and it's a super derogatory term with connotations of barbarism, subhumanity, and so on and so forth. Now, the technically correct term that we use for the community is the Chor Chapori Muslims. Chor Chaporis are the river banks and the river islands of Assam where this community largely lives. Write down, I am a Miyah. Write. Write down, I am a Miyah. My serial number in the NRC is 2,543. I have two children, and there is coming next summer. Will you hate him as you hate me? Write, I am a Miyah. I turn waste marshy lands to green paddy fields to feed you. I carry bricks to build your buildings, drive your car, for your comfort, clean your drain, to keep you healthy. I have always been in your service, and yet you are dissatisfied. Write down, I am a Miyah, a citizen of a democratic, secular republic, without any rights, my mother, a D-voter, though her parents are Indian. Thank you. Nana, I have written, attested, countersigned, and been verified by a public notary that I am a Miyah. Now see me rise from flood waters, float over landslides, march through sand and marsh and snakes, break the earth's will, draw trenches with spades, crawl through fields of rice and diarrhea and sugarcane, and a 10% literacy rate. See me shrug my shoulders, curl my hair, read two lines of poetry, one formula of math, read confusion when the bullies call me Bangladeshi, and tell my revolutionary heart, but I am a Miyah. See me hold by my side the Constitution, point a finger to Delhi, walk to my parliament, my Supreme Court, my Connaught Place, and tell the MPs, the esteemed judges, and the ladies selling trinkets and her charm on Janpat, well, I am a Miyah. Visit me in Kolkata, in Nagpur, in the Simapuri slums. See me suited in Silicon Valley, suited at McDonald's, enslaved in Birwa, bright trafficked in Mewat. See the stains on my childhood, the gold medals on my PhD certificate. Then call me Salma, call me Aman, call me Abdul, call me Bahatun Nessa, or call me Gulam. See me catch a plane, get a visa, catch a bullet train, catch a bullet, catch your drift, catch a rocket, wear a lungi to space, and there where no one can hear you scream thunder, I am Miyah, I am proud. Thank you. I beg to state that I am a settler, a hated Miyah. Whatever be the case, my name is Ismail Sheikh, Ramzan Ali, or Majid Miyah. Subject, I am an Assamese Akhomiya. I have many things to say, stories older than Assam's folk tales, stories older than the blood flowing through your veins. After 40 years of independence, I have no space in the words of beloved writers. The brush of your script writers doesn't dip in my picture. My name left unpronounced in assemblies and parliaments. On no martyr's memorial, on no news report is my name printed, even in tiny letters. Besides, you haven't yet decided what to call me. Am I Miyah, Akhomiya, or Neo-Akhomiya? I live with a strange dream. I cannot sleep. Night glitters and my heart flutters. My ears pop like a rabbit's. On this new moon night, I see every day on my calendar stained in blood. You have seen blood all your life, I tell my heart. Why are you scared of blood? I close my eyes. Another handful of fear rumbles in my belly. May is not marked in blood. The Bekis waters have washed it clean. I was scared in Khograbari. I walked through the Beki and reached Majid Bhita. Hashar's 1.5-year-old boy drowned and his body hardened one fine day in June. Nearby, Uncle Fazal trembles like a leaf. Uncle has a fever, hasn't eaten for 2 days. He sits on a bamboo bed the size of a calendar. Auntie trembles like a leaf. What if the waters rise some more? The wet calendar dries, fear drenches my mind. In a dark room, my hands turn the pages. A damned fox, maybe a civet, stole my hens. The cacophony of chickens struts over my calendar. Sister Halimon has left her 3-month-old child in Kokrajhar. Sister Hasina had her baby there. In 4 years, the little boy has not known the outside of a coop. My world shivers in fear. I cannot sleep. Lend me some strength, friends. Lend me some false hope. For one night, just one night on this calendar, let me sleep. I am yet a Miyah. Mine is the story of a burning, bone-crunching sun. My manhood, the cautionary tale of bent shoulders and the pricking of salted thorns. Mine is the story of grow more food. Grow more food was a policy under which the British brought the peasants to Assam. Mine is the story of grow more food, man-eaters, cholera, diarrhea, and a fragrant revolution scattered by my fathers in a forest of thorns. Mine is a story of heroes. Mine is the sacrificial offering of 1951, of blood screaming through the binds of history. Mine is a story of 83, 90, 94, 2008, 2012, 2014. Mine is the oppression, the ignominy, the deprivation of Dravidians in Pragjyotishpur, Pragjyotishpur being the older name of Assam. I am the color of a shame, holding its ears, bending its knees, while kings and dynasties pass. I am the one under the fool's cap, standing in line with dumb cattle. I am a painting of heritage hung in a stable, because though the bottles look different, the wine is still the same. And judging by birth alone, I am yet a Miyah. That land that makes my father an alien, that kills my brother with bullets, my sister with gang rape, the land where my mother stokes in her heart live burning coals, that land is mine. I am not of that land. The land where my claim over a lungi is suspect, where there are no ears for cries, where demanding rights throws you under the plummeting fists of ghosts. The land which demands eternal servitude, that land is mine. I am not of that land. The land where a cap is radicalism, a Miyah subhuman, every chorua a Bangladeshi. Chorua means a person who lives on the chor. So, every chorua a Bangladeshi, where earth is weighed and sold to Tatas, Birlas, and Ambanis, Godrejes. That land is mine, I'm not of that land. The land where limb after limb is chopped and sent afloat the river, where in 83 the executioners dance, a shameless, grisly dance of celebration. That land is mine, I am not of that land. The land where my home and hearth is uprooted, where my heritage is negated, where they conspire to bind me forever in darkness, where they pour gravel, not gruel, on my plate. That land is mine. I am not of that land. The land where my throat cracks with appeals and no one hears, where my blood flows cheap and no one pays, where they play politics with my son's coffin and cards with my daughter's honor. The land where I wander crazy, confused as a beast. That land is mine. I'm not of that land. Hussain Miyah rode a bicycle. The handlebars had two flags on either side, hammers and sickles. In a glimmer, Hussain Miyah cycled through 50 years, through villages and zigzag paths. Hussain Miyah took the aisle through mustard fields. When he came to our village, children ran behind his cycle screaming, "Comrade, comrade." Hussain Miyah knew no revolution. He had no Marx. What Lenin blabbered about from which land was Ho Chi Minh, Hussain Miyah had no clue. Hussain Miyah didn't know if consumerism was to be eaten or rubbed on the scalp. Hussain Miyah knew nothing except that the Red Party was for the poor. Hussain Miyah knew whose blood the cap-wearing leaders sucked. Hussain Miyah knew that the land was of the workers, the land was of blood and sweat. Every year the votes came and Hussain Miyah's clothes turned red. Someone drew a hammer and a sickle on his chest. From riverbank to riverbank came the tinkling of his cycle bell. There goes Hussain Miyah, there's his raised fist, Lal Salam, Lal Salam. For 10 years, I have not seen Hussain Miyah. Since the cold morning he came coughing, he ate two handfuls of rice with a koi fish and raised an Ameen to God. Since then, I only wake up in the middle of the night because a cycle comes pedaling through my dream, red flags on the handlebars, and voices crying, Lal Salam, Lal Salam. I walk through a half village, half town. Over my head, the cheap sky has opened a rain shop. 100 years of darkness turns to snow, puddles and ponds drawn in the rain. In this rain, I too am getting wet. In my heart, cotton balls of rain float like a stifled cry. I skid in the rain, death slips in a gutter. I walk up from the final wound of death and I limp across the cheap town. I walk and I remember the story of a bird. A bird that sits in a faraway rain-starved city on top of a leafless, branchless tree. Whenever I remember the bird, I forget the darkness, my limp legs, this cheap sky and my childhood, those black days of agony of the hungry youth I forget, and I become blind and I am left with no fear of falling in the gutter. I have told the bird I'll bring her a tree of life. Let there be no branch, no leaves. I will still be there like a deathless shadow. I have told her, at the end of every black night of her city, I will come by the morning train, cutting through the mountain of light like it happens in every half story. My endless journey will not be like that. I know this darkness, this storm, this deathly cold, it's nothing. I will have to cross a vast sea of anguish. I will have to traverse a slippery century like an even powerful monster. I have given her my word. I'll come with the taste of wet rain in my heart, carrying all the foliage of a half forest. With the croaking of frogs in heat, I will come to the port of a dusty city like an ancient sailor. I walk through a half village and half town. With death-like agony, I walk along, suffering, limping. The cheap sky has opened a rain shop over my head. In my heart, cottons of rain float like a muffled cry. O humanness, when the kadam's scent spreads, the koel will call, a breeze will rise from the distant sea, and I will come by the morning train. Something rustles in the backyard. Someone walks by in the peak of night. It's a cold, cold January. In the rice fields, someone climbs a mountain of mist. My hands shake, my feet tremble. Someone taps on the bamboo wall. A voice slips on the air. Rohimka, open the door. It's Omlan. There's talk of new days. In this season of hunger, someone sows hope. Only a gun can give you a mouthful to eat, they say. A swarm of new flags swoops in. Every mouth is stuffed with new slogans. Someone lights a torch in the woods. The boots come trampling in the countryside. A sister cries, mother, oh mother, a brother's corpse is found. In wave after wave, a sum of the 90s flows. Dry air cracks with a boom. I can't sleep. Someone walks by. Someone taps on the bamboo wall. Thank you.